I don't really ever remember a time when art wasn't a part of who I am. I didn't spend a lot of time outdoors as a child. I used to go over to my grandmother's house and paint comic books with one of my uncles. They were very vibrant and bold in their use of color and their use of shading. Back then, we had things that were called albums. And albums came in sleeves, and the sleeves had cover art. And the art was filled with all sorts of paintings, drawings, photography, just anything you could think of. So that was a big influence on me back then as well, as a child. I didn't really have a style for a long time. I guess my style, since the majority of what I did involved just drawing with a pencil, I loved to draw things that looked real, which was kind of a contrast from where I started drawing. But I think at the beginning it was realism, trying to make things look real. I didn't have any real focus. I started to explore with color usage. But there was no certain style that was pinpointed. It was very eclectic, all over the place. I was influenced by a lot of modern art, of course, like Picasso and things of cubism, and with expressionism, some abstract. It wasn't until I kind of had a happy accident whilst using palette knives. I started to use palette knives mainly to mix paint and mix colors. Once I started to use it more for application, I discovered the use of angles, and using a palette knife completely lent itself to that type of application, using angles. The style that I use now, I call angular expressionism. If you notice, my paintings do not have any curves. It's all angles. It's all straight lines, straight edges. I do this because it kind of reflects the way life is. Life is very rigid, very angular. It's not smooth. It doesn't always go the way we want it to. It cuts you off. It redirects you suddenly. When you see the shapes and the colors in my paintings, that's what I want it to reflect. I've taken great pleasure in interpreting different things from songs that I've heard, from movies that I've seen. Nowadays, I tend to try to stretch a little bit further in my inspirations, but I do get influenced by the world around me and what I can contribute to it. It's always a great feeling to get commissioned by somebody to do a piece of art. I think more and more now that people are starting to see the style that I produce, and it's getting in front of more eyes. It's beginning to catch on a little bit, the style that I use, and in order to be commissioned by somebody is a great honor. I was fortunate enough to meet Kiki and Doug, the directors here at Gallery Midtown, before they even started here. So we were friendly before that. But when they came here, they invited me to display my art here as well. And this place is great. Any kind of art you can think of is represented here, be it paintings, sculpture, glassware, clothing. I mean, there's something for everybody's taste. I have been told that my style is quite original, and I'm happy about that. I think that everybody borrows from everybody, and some of us steal from some people. So there's not a whole lot of complete originality in the world, but if you can put your own personality to it and be serious about that, it will shine through. My biggest desire comes from art is to be able to share it with more people. I want to be more prolific. I want to have enough time to produce everything that I'm feeling. I'll do as many as I can using this style.